Good day, ladies and gentlemen, once again, another recording opportunity on question 3.23 of the question bank for management accounting 3761 or management accounting MAC3701. Yeah, I think 3701. Now, I normally start reading on the requirements before I start analyzing the information provided. But as per today, I decide not to go through the requirements, but we'll come back to the requirements after we are done with the analysis. First, I will analyze the first part of the work, which is the first department. As we are scanning, we can see that we have division mountain. Here we have division mountain, which is the second division. We can see that obviously there is a first division. So our information is divided into two divisions. So we read the first division, analyze the first division. Then after we answer the questions on the first division, then after we go to the second division, analyze and respond to the questions that relate to that division. Because if you read all of them, there's a likelihood that you might not cope with the amount of work that you are to analyze and come back and answer the question. You might be a little bit confused. So let us begin. AQUA First PTY LTD is the mineral bottling, is the mineral water bottling and selling company. They bottle and sell water, which is mineral water. Its financial year end is 30th of April 2000, each and every year. AQUA's water bottling process is undertaken in two independent divisions, which are called Division Valley and Division Mountain. Division Valley is responsible for the manufacturing of all the empty glass bottles, while Division Mountain, which is Div Mau, is responsible for the harvesting. The second division, they do harvesting, they do preparing, they do distilling, and the bottling of the prepared mineral water into bottles. Another one just produces the bottle, then there is a possibility, obviously, here of a transfer price or transfer system, where Division Valley produces the bottles and sell the bottles to Division Mountain in order for Division Mountain to do the harvesting, preparing, distilling, and bottling of this mineral water into the bottles that are manufactured by Division Valley. So there's a possible transfer price policy that is to take place here. Notwithstanding the selling of the empty glass bottles from Division Valley to Division Mount, meaning there is already a selling of these bottles, AQUA does not currently have a transfer pricing system in place. So they don't have a transfer pricing system in place. However, Division Valley produce some of the bottles or all of the bottles and sells them to Division Mountain. So there is a selling of these bottles in between the two divisions, although there's no transfer system in place. The company is using first in, first out, which is FIFO method, very great to hear that, to value all of its inventory types. Its cost of capital and the target return on investment is 11.5% and 12.5% per annum respectively. The minute you are given the cost of capital, then there is a possibility that we will be required to calculate residual income, because in the calculation of residual income, you get to controllable profit, then after you deduct the cost of capital charged, where you say cost of capital, you multiply this by the controllable investment, then you deduct that from your controllable profit in order to get to your residual income. So there's a possible question on the residual income, and the fact that we do have a target return on investment could be an indication that the divisional manager or one of the divisional managers will have to be evaluated in terms of his performance to check if does he or she qualify to get a bonus. If the actual return on investment is more than the target return on investment, then the divisional manager will qualify to get a bonus, probably together with his team, obviously, because he or she was not working alone. It further says that each divisional manager is entitled to receive a performance bonus, exactly, provided their division meets or exceed the target return on investment. So now that means if the actual return on investment is equal to 12.50, which is meeting the target return, then the divisional manager will get a bonus. And also, if the divisional manager's actual return on investment is above, meaning exceed that 12.5, then is going to be still entitled to the performance bonus based on the return on the investment targets. Now we have division value, which is the first division. I will analyze, try to write some stuff down, which will help us in response to some of the questions. And my analysis is responding to some of the questions. So meaning that if I have analyzed information and in the requirements, they require me to calculate what I've already written in my calculations, then I don't have to rewrite that in terms of the solution. I'll just refer you to my workings. Then after it says, but when you respond in your exam, even if you do have the workings, make sure that there's a part where you answer, then some of the calculations or workings of the calculation you will not show in your solution because you already have the workings. Then you just have to refer the examiner to your workings for some of the calculations, because you'll only take final amounts, not the calculation 1 plus or whatsoever, because there are workings there on top. Division values maximum normal manufacturing capacity is 1,400,000 empty 500 milliliter glass bottles per annum. So this division, remember, they produce bottles, and they are maximum, meaning they cannot produce more than 1.4 million. Then it says the division's market segmentation of external sales to internal sales is 35% is to 65% for the 2018 financial year. Remember, there was a sentence that said, notwithstanding the selling of the empty glass bottles from Division Valley to Division Mountain, AQUAS does not have the transfer price system in place. Now we can see that sentence is in agreement with this, because 65% of what this division produces, they sell it to Division Mountain, of which 35% is to the external market. So there is a selling of these bottles internally, but there is no transfer pricing system in place. So let us just calculate their production and sales, normal production and sales, because we have the normal manufacturing capacity. So now this is still under the first division, maximum capacity, maximum production capacity. Equals 1,400,000 500 milliliter empty bottles, E bottles. Then now we have external sales at a normal maximum capacity will be 1.4 million times by 35%, because they sell 35% of what they produce to the external market. 1,400,000 times by 0.35. This gives us 490,000 units. You can feel free to say units, but know that these units are 500 milliliter empty bottles. Then obviously the difference of that 1,400,000 will be internal sales, which is 910,500 milliliter empty bottles, which are the units that they are producing and selling. Then after we have our internal normal production and sales. 1,400,000 rands times by 65%. Remember, now that we have done these workings, if these numbers are needed in our requirements, you don't have to show this calculation. You can just say internal sales or maximum internal sales 910,000. Then after to the examiner, you say refer to working number one. Then after we could have written there on top division value. We could have written a heading there, division value. Very important to highlight which division you are dealing with, so that the examiner does not hassle in terms of the workings. Let us just verify this 1.4 million times by 0.65. It is 910,000 units, which is maximum sales when they reach their maximum production. Now, it further say that the manufacturing of the MD 580 milliliter glass bottles occurs in proportion similar to the division's market segmentation throughout each financial year, meaning it does not matter how many units they produce, but 35% of that will be sold external and 65% of that will be sold internal. So they maintain this market segmentation, or the proportion of the market segmentation. The division's profit markup on all external sales, take note, on all of this 35%, the division sells them to external market at 25% on all inclusive manufacturing cost. And I want to bring your attention to something that is normally in the first paragraph. They say on all inclusive manufacturing cost, meaning they take the total cost, they take the total cost per unit, then they add markup percentage, meaning term this by 125%. So now it is cost plus markup percentage that becomes the selling price only to the external market. For the internal market, it seems as if there's no markup, since this is the last sentence. Now, we at this stage don't know if this company is using, or this division is using, absorption costing or is using marginal costing, which is called direct costing. We don't know that yet, but I'm just bothered by this these few words or this phrase that says on all inclusive manufacturing costs. Most of the time in the first paragraph, they will tell you that the company is using direct method or absorption method, but they kept silent in this case. And most of the time when they keep quiet, they'll ask you a requirement there and ask you if which inventory system or which reporting system does this company use. So by the fact that they say on all inclusive manufacturing cost, is an indication on me that they are including all the cost, but we have to look at further information that will convince us more. Now there is 1.1, which is 2018 financial budget. 1.1 2018 financial budget. We have 2018 financial budget. Now let us look at what are they budgeting to produce and what are they budgeting to sell in 2018. At the back of our mind, we know that what they produce, they have a market segmentation of 35% going to external, 65 to internal. The division is expected to manufacture and sell 85% of its normal manufacturing capacity. Remember, there is the normal manufacturing capacity of 1.4 million. So the division budgeted production and sales. Division budgeted production and sales. That is 1.1. Division value budgeted production and sales. Their budgeted production and sales, it is 85%, is equal to 1,400,000 rands times by 85%. That is what they budgeting to manufacture and sell, times 0.85. That means they are targeting, or they are budgeting or planning to produce 1,190,000 units. Then out of that, we know that there is external sales. External sales, and their external sales are maintained 1,190,000 units times by 35%, times 0.35, that is 416,500 milliliter bottles, empty bottles. Then after we have our internal sales or internal transfer, our internal sales is 1,190,000 empty bottles. 65% of what they produce is sold internally. Divide by 0.35 goes back, times by 0.65. It is 773,500 units. So division value is planning to produce or is planning to sell 773,500 empty bottles to Division Mountain, because 65% of what they produce, they sell to internal division. So 416,000 is what they plan to sell external, according to the market segmentation that they have. Then after, let us continue further on that same note. 1.1.1, it is very important when you're doing your workings, you number according to the information provided, so that when you want to make a reference for your numbers in your solution, let us say we are required to calculate how many units should be sold external, of which we see how many units are budgeted to be sold external in 2018. These are the number of units. If we can be required that in the requirement, we will just say budgeted 2018 sales, external sales, 416,500. Then you say refer to 1.1.1. Then the examiner will refer to 1.1.1 and say that we have done your workings. So hence it is important that you also number your workings very well. It will make things easier for you to do reference for your calculations. Then let us analyze the next part of the work. We are provided under 1.2.2 with a standard all-inclusive manufacturing cost of one empty 500 milliliter glass bottle, which is provided to us. For this division to produce a glass, they need raw glass. And this raw glass is 600 grams at 3 rand per kg. We can see that this is kg and these are grams. So we need to convert the grams into equivalent kgs. So to do that, you say 600 grams divide by the number of grams in 1 kg. And 1 kg is made of 1,000 grams. So now when you do that, it will give you 0.6 kgs, meaning 600 grams is equivalent to 0.6 kgs. Now that we have the kgs and the prices per kg, then you can multiply the 0.6 with the 3 rand in order to get to the price per unit. 0.6 times by 3, it will give us 1 rand 80 cent. That means the cost of a unit in terms of raw glass, it is 1 rand 80 cent. So let us draft under 1.1.2 our standard information. Our standard information. Then we have 1.1.1.2, which is our standard cost per unit. Our standard cost per unit. And remember, this is 2018 financial year budget. This is under budgeted information. I just want to bring that to your attention. So we need raw glass. And our raw glass is 600, very important to show the full workings there as opposed to 0.6. is equal to 0.6 times by 3. You don't have to say equal 0.6, you can just get to the final answer of 1 rand 80 cents. Then after the further cost that is needed, it is bottle cap, and the bottle cap requirement is that each bottle requires one steel cap at 20 cents per cap, and one bottle need only one cap. So we need a bottle cap, and this bottle cap is already per unit, which is 20 cents. We don't have to multiply that. Then after, we need direct labor. Our direct labor, it takes 4.5, meaning 4 minutes and 30 seconds to complete one unit according to the labor hours. So it is 4 hours 15 minutes, and the employees are paid per hour, which is 6 rand per hour of direct labor. They are not paid per minute. The rate of labor is normally a rate per hour. So now we need to convert the minutes into equivalent hours. We do the same thing. We say 4.5 divided by 60. This will give us the equivalence of these minutes. Divide by 60. Therefore, now these minutes are equivalent to 0.075 hours, which is obviously less than an hour. Then we multiply this hourly equivalent by the rate per hour. Make sure that your staff is always converted into the same units. Then we have our direct labor, which is 4.5 divided by 60, gives us 0.075. We multiply this by 6, then it will give us the correct answer of labor. That means in terms of the direct labor cost, we incur 45 cents to complete one unit. Then now let us check the next cost. The next cost that we are given, it is the variable manufacturing overheads. Variable manufacturing overheads, it is 12 rand per direct labor hour, meaning we need to multiply this by the number of hours it takes to complete one unit, which we calculated above, because our variable overhead are based on direct labor hours or absorbed from direct labor hours. So now we have our variable manufacturing overheads. Please don't write abbreviation. I'm just writing abbreviation to save time. 0.075 times by 12. Therefore now, obviously this will times by 2, it will give us 0.90. 0.075 times by 12, it is 0.90. The reason why, because previously it was 6, so this number was double 10, so I just times it by 2 in the beginning. So we have 0.90. Remember, these are what you call incremental cost. These are what you call variable cost or incremental cost. When we are taking a decision, meaning a decision of saying at what price must this bottle is to be sold to Division Mountain, because we are producing these 500 milliliter glass bottles and 65% of them, we transfer them to Division Mountain. So now if we do that, the question is at what price must we transfer them? If there is available capacity to sell both internal and external, of which I assume there should be available capacity because this division is already selling 65% of what they produce to the internal division. So now that means there is available capacity. There is no loss of sales that could have been sold external. So now if that is the case, meaning if there is enough capacity to sell internal, there will be no compromise of the external sales. Therefore, the recommended minimum transfer price will be the total incremental cost, which is the total variable cost. So 0.90 plus 0.45 plus 0.20 plus 1.8 will give us 3 rand 35 cents. This will be recommended transfer price because there is enough capacity and there is no lost contribution. So now that will mean we say this will be incremental cost or variable cost. incremental cost. This cost the increase as the production increase, or you can say variable production cost. Variable production cost. Please bear with me with the abbreviation, and also space in this case is the limiting factor. Then now we need to look at another cost that we have. Another cost, it is the fixed manufacturing overheads. Now, the fact that we have fixed manufacturing overheads is one of the indications that this company is using absorption costing. This company is using absorption costing because they include all the manufacturer, all the production cost in the calculation of the cost of a product. So now that is why, meaning they are not using absorption costing. Here we already have our fixed cost per unit as 45 cents. So we have our fixed cost as 45 cents, 0.45. Then after we can get to our total cost, 0.45 plus 3.35. This gives us 3.80. So now this is the total cost per unit, or we sometimes call it absorption cost. If you want, you can say absorption cost. When you say absorption cost, we are indicating that fixed cost or fixed manufacturing cost have been included in the calculation of this cost per unit. Now, remember, all this information is budgeted or is standard. And we can calculate also our selling price. We can calculate our selling price. Why am I saying that? Is because we were told that there is a markup percentage of 25% on cost. So now, meaning we can say 380 times by 1.25, meaning the company is budgeting to sell their product to the external market. Take note, the markup percentage of 25% was only to the external market. For the internal, we don't know the price, but we know that there is a recommended price, a price that we are recommending so far, if there's a requirement, that because there is enough capacity to sell both internal and external, therefore the recommended transfer price to sell to this internal division should be at incremental cost, which is 3.35. So now this will be our standard or our budgeted selling price, 4.75. We are going to be given an actual selling price if there will be a difference between what we planned in terms of the price and what actually took place in terms of the price, also including the cost, because the cost will affect the price. Now we have covered 1.2. Now we go to 1.1.3. It says variable selling cost is budgeted at 5 cents per each unit of 500 milliliter MD glass bottle, and it is only incurred for external sales. The total budgeted fixed selling cost is expected to be 105,000 rand. So the fixed selling cost, it is fixed at 105,000 rand. Very important to highlight that. But the variable one, it is 5 cents. Remember, this varies with the number of units that were sold. Every unit we sell, we incur 5 cents of the selling cost. Very important to highlight that, because I will explain it also further why that is very important. Now, it further says that the fixed manufacturing overheads are absorbed based on the budgeted operating capacity. So now, our fixed costs are based on the budgeted operating capacity, meaning now we need to say 0.45, meaning if we want to know our total fixed cost, we need to know our budgeted operating capacity. Our budgeted operating capacity was 1,190,000 rands. That 1,190,000 rands was 85% of the normal manufacturing capacity, because the company expected or budgeted to manufacture and sell 85% of the normal manufacturing capacity. And that normal manufacturing capacity is 1.4 million. And 85% of that gave us 1,190,000 rands. And now when they are telling us that our budgeted fixed cost were based on the budgeted operating capacity, which is 1,190,000. It means we can say 1,190,000 times by 0.45, times this by 0.45, or 0.45 times by 1,190,000. This will give us the budgeted fixed cost. This will give us the budgeted fixed manufacturing cost or overheads. 0.45 times by 1,190,000 rands, it will give us 535,500. This is 535,500. So now our budgeted fixed manufacturing overheads are 535,500. That is under 1.1.3, there was nothing. 1.1.4, we're calculating our budgeted fixed manufacturing overheads, which are equal to 1,190,000 rands. We already know where this number is coming from, times by 0.45, then this gives us 535,500 rands. Now, if we were to calculate our total fixed cost, we already know that we have 105,000 rands, which is our fixed selling cost. This is fixed manufacturing cost. So now, remember, when calculating break-even point, we calculate all the fixed costs. So now, our total fixed cost will be equal to 535,500 plus 105,000 rands of the fixed selling cost plus 105,000. This gives us 640,500 rands. This gives us 640,000. So this is our total fixed cost. I'm not sure if it will be needed in the future or not. I'm just analyzing as much as my brain can allow me to analyze. Then after we go to 1.2, it is the extract or an extract of the actual information. We're coming from budgeted, now we are going to actual. Then now let us go to 1.2, which is actual information. Under 1.2, we have actual data that we need to take into account. 1.2, it is 2018 actual. Financial data or financial information. Now let us see what actually took place. Is actual information different from what we budgeted? That we don't know as per yet. We are given an extract of the income statement or statement of profit and loss, and this statement is presented into two ways. The two ways are referred to be external and internal with the total column. External, internal, and the total column. Now, meaning we know obviously that there are always external sales, which are amount to 35% of what we produce. We know that there are internal sales, which amount to 65% of the units that we have produced. Now, under our sales, there are no figures, but they gave us alphabet number A. The note is very important whenever you are given information in columns. When they say note A, you go straight to note A and you analyze regarding that, because that will help you. Now, it says, throughout the financial year, the actual all-inclusive manufacturing cost per unit were equivalent to the standard all-inclusive manufacturing cost. Very important. I thought I would bypass that. It says actual all-inclusive manufacturing cost, meaning our actual cost. Remember, I want to bring you to this terminology, all-inclusive manufacturing cost. I'm not sure if you still remember that one. They said the standard all-inclusive manufacturing cost. So now they are referring to this information, but the actual one. meaning the cost per unit actual, what was the cost per unit in actual fact. So now they say the actual all-inclusive manufacturing cost per unit were equivalent or were the same, I just want to use the word same, were equivalent to the standard all-inclusive manufacturing cost. That means, in simple terms, the standard information per unit, which is 3 rand 80 cent, is equal to actual. That's what they are telling us, meaning there is no variance, there is no difference. So meaning the cost of glass was the same. Remember, this is standard cost per unit, which is all inclusive. I should have said that all inclusive manufacturing cost, meaning the cost of glass was actually the same, the cost of bottle cap was actually the same, the cost of lip was actually the same, the cost of variable manufacturing overheads was actually the same, and the cost of fixed cost was actually the same, which therefore means that the total cost per unit is actually the same, which therefore means that if the markup percentage is still remain at 25%, therefore the actual selling price is the same as the standard or budgeted selling price, 4.75. So now if that is the case, let us now check if do we have markup percentage remaining at 25%. External sales were made at an actual profit markup of 25% on all inclusive manufacturing cost. Now that means our standard information per unit is the same as actual information per unit. So now meaning this selling price is the same as actual, 4.75. If that is the case, then it will be easier for us to calculate the external sales if they give us the number of units that were sold to the external market, which is 388,500 external units were. Let us continue before I jump to the next sentence. The following units of MT500 glass bottles were actually manufactured and sold for the 2018 financial year. So this is what was manufactured in total and sold. I want to just give you the total of all these figures. 388,500 plus 721,500. The total production and sales was 1,110,000 units, meaning 500 milliliter glass bottles. Glass bottles. So this is the total units that they produced and sold. Now I just want to test if did they maintain their market segmentation? Did they maintain their market segmentation of 35%? Is to 65%. I just want to check that, hence I'm totalizing all this, because that might be crucial for other future requirements. So 1,110,000 units times by 0.35. Definitely, they are very, 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 very solid to their market segmentation agreement that 35% of what they produce and sell will be external. And obviously 65% of 1,110,000 rands will be sold to the internal division. There is 721,500. So I'm happy that they are consistent when it comes to that. Now let us calculate our external sales. We know that our selling price is 4.75 because it is the same as standard and the markup is the same. So we term this by 388,500. After we got to that, we can say that our external sales will amount to 1,845,375. That will be our external sales. We do have our total sales. If we deduct our total sales from external sales, we get our internal sales. So minus 4,587,075 equals 2 million, let me just change the color here, equals 2,741,700. So we already know that our internal sales are 2,741,700. Now if If, let us say that, not if, let me say, since I recommended, don't want to say if, since I recommended that the internal selling price or the internal transfer price should be at variable cost. Why? Because there is enough capacity to sell both internal and external. That is my explanation of the reasoning. Why am I recommending this price? Is because there is enough capacity to sell both internal and external, and there is no lost contribution, or there are no units that were supposed to be sold in external but now they are transferred internal. So there is no lost contribution. That is why I recommended this price. So now, if that is the case, we'll also deal with that when it comes to the cost of sales for the income statement. But now let us go to cost of sales. Cost of sales still under number A, and we have seen that number A has the same information, nothing else, because they produce these units. Then now, what is important under cost of sales is the fact that here we need to say how much did it cost us to produce the 388,500, which was sold externally. How much did it cost us? Remember, it was the same as budgeted. So now it costed us 3.80. So now we have to say 3.80, 3.80 times by 388,500. This gives us 1,476,300. 1,476,300. 1,000,000. I don't want you. 1,476,300. Then after this will give us the gross profit minus 1,845,375. This gives us 369,075. So this becomes our gross profit. Now the fact that we have gross profit is also another indication, or is another sign which is consistent with the absorption costing. The minute we say gross profit, that means this is consistent with the absorption costing reporting. And at the same time, the term cost of sales. Cost of sales means all the costs have been included, meaning all inclusive costs have been taken into account in the calculation of the cost per product. So I'm explaining to you why I'm saying the company or the division is using absorption costing. That is normally a requirement in such a case. If there is no profit, let me say if there is no profit that is made on all internal sales, that means the cost of sales will be the same as the selling price. It will be the same 2,741,700. Therefore, now gross profit will be zero. If there is no profit made on the sales that are coming from the external or the internal market. So now under total here, we'll have 369,075. Now let us continue. Remember, this is still a question. We don't know if there's a profit made on internal sales or not. Then when you see such information, then we'll deal with it accordingly. If there's no profit made on internal sales, then we'll be happy. All this information will be correct. You can just copy it and paste it in our requirements later on. Now let me also write under total of my cost of sales. My total of cost of sales will be 1,476,300 plus 2,741,700. Then this gives me equal negative 4,218,000. 4,218,000 minus 4,587,075, just to verify, it is 369,075. So still correct on that one. I'm already completing this income statement, though, although I'm doing the calculate the workings. We have our variable fixed and selling cost of 123,310. This is very important for you to master. Good for you to increase your analysis skills. Very important. Now, the information that is provided under number A, specifically in terms of these numbers, if they want, they cannot tell you anything about this. They can keep quiet here, and they can keep quiet and hide these numbers in this amount. The question is how? They can tell you that the variable selling cost remained the same under actual. And now if the variable selling cost remained the same, meaning now the variable selling cost will be 0.05, which is 5 cents. If that was the case, they will not tell you how much was produced and sold. You will have to discover it from this number, this 123,310. Now, why am I saying that? It's because out of this 123, I know that 105,000 is fixed selling cost. And if the fixed selling cost also remain the same as 105,000, then it is easier for me to say 123,310 minus 105,000. It will give me 18,000. Now I'm calculating the variable selling cost. 18,310, meaning out of this 123,310, 105,000, we know that it is fixed. If it were the same as budgeted, so now it will remain as same as actual. So if it was the same, that means 18,310 will be our actual variable total selling cost. Now, if this variable selling cost per unit is the same as it was planned, would be meaning 0.05 cents. If it was the same as budgeted, meaning it was this 5 cents. If that were the case, then these numbers can be hidden. This number that we're working on here can be hidden, and you'll have to find them by means of this 18,000. So now this 18,000, we know that it was units produced times by this variable selling cost of 0.05, but we don't know if it was the same or not. So now, in other words, we'll have to say 18,310 divided by the variable selling cost per unit. Do you see that it gives us 366,200? So that means the examiner did not give us further information about the variable selling cost and fixed cost. And I would have loved to get some clarity on this, so that when I'm verifying this 388,000 via the variable selling cost, it should be giving me the same amount, because I am told nothing. So that means our variable actual selling price or selling cost was not the same as it was budgeted, or maybe there was an increase in the fixed selling cost. That is why now when we verify that, it gave us 366,200 instead of 388,500. Yeah, so please be mindful of the fact that all this 388,000 and 721,000 could have been hidden in this number, where you must remove how much is fixed, then we are left with what is variable. Then what is variable, you divide with the variable cost of it per unit, which is 0.5 cents. That will give you the number of units that were sold external. Then now, the minute you know the number of units that were sold external, you know these numbers, it is 35%. You multiply by 100, divide by 35, it will give you the total number of units that were manufactured, including internal and external. Then after from that total, you multiply by 65% in order to get to the number of units that were manufactured and sold internal. So please, guys, master this. If you happen not to grab what I'm explaining, which is very crucial, don't hesitate to contact me on my current number, which is 072-030-3652. Now let us continue in lieu of that broader analysis there. Then interest income on fixed deposit 68,500. Other operating cost, which is under number B, they are 350,000 rands, and they are telling us that under number B that included in this amount of 350,000 rands, it is allocated head office expenses, meaning we need to remove this. Remember, this will be negative, so we need to say plus 205,000 rands. 4,500 interest expense on the bank overdraft at Imali Bank. Each divisional manager or division is solely responsible for the management of its cash and cash equivalents. So now that means the interest that was on the bank overdraft is the sole responsibility of the divisional manager. So now, since the 4.5 is included in this amount, we don't have to remove it because it is supposed to be there, because the divisional manager is responsible for the cash management, or for the management of cash and cash equivalent. So when we are evaluating the performance of this divisional manager, we must keep the 4.5 in there, but we can't keep the 205,000 because that is a cost the divisional manager has no control over. When we are evaluating the performance of the division or the divisional manager, we look at the cost that the manager has control over and incomes that the manager has control over, so that we evaluate the performance over what the manager has control and is responsible for it. 85,000 is municipal rates and taxes for the head office administration building. The head office is not the division this manager is busy with. So the head office allocated municipal rates and taxes are not controlled by the divisional manager. And in that case, the 85,000 must also be removed from that 350,000 rands, because we cannot be evaluated. It will be unfair for us to evaluate the manager on the cost that he does not have control over. So now we look for the cost where the divisional manager has a control over. Then we evaluate the performance by calculating controllable profit, and also getting to the residual income and calculating the return on investment. Last sentence on this division says the division's actual controllable investment at 30 April 2018 was 205,000 rands. We do have the controllable investment. Remember, controllable investment, it is your assets minus your liabilities that gives you your owner's equity. Or else, if you are given the assets only, if the manager only controls the assets, therefore now the assets minus the depreciation, then that will give you the carrying value. So that will be your controllable investment at the end of the accounting period, or at the point when the divisional manager is evaluated. Remember, you can be given the cost of the asset at the beginning of the year. Cost of an asset on the 1st of May 20 whatsoever. Then after they tell you how much is the depreciation, then after they say calculate the return on investment. Therefore now you need to adjust the cost of the assets by the depreciation, so that you get the carrying value of such assets, and the carrying value of such assets at the end of the accounting period or at the evaluation of the performance date will give you the controllable investment. Now I'm done with the first division. What does that mean? That means I'm going to the requirements that are regarding this division. Then after, I will respond to the requirements concerning this one. I have analyzed all that I could analyze as much as I can. Now other things are still if up until we get all the information that we want. Now depending at the same time to what is required, but as I said, if this, then we'll see what the requirement are telling us. Identify the costing system used by AQUA for its internal reporting purposes and also for assigning costs to its products. Briefly motivate your answer by making reference to the relevant information from the scenario. We need to first I identify the costing system, and I said that the cost AQUA is, or AQUA uses absorption costing system for internal reporting. That's what you say. You state what the company, the division is using. AQUA is using absorption costing system for its internal reporting and for assigning cost to product. Why I'm saying also for assigning cost to product, I can see there is a fixed absorption rate. So now it means they are using absorption costing for internal reporting and for assigning cost to product. How do I motivate that? My motivation is the fact that I want to use the very clear one. My motivation is the fact that there is a gross profit. That means gross profit is an indication that, or it is consistent with the absorption costing system. In the income statement, we say gross profit, which is consistent with the absorption costing system. At the same time, you can, I think, use the same cost of sales, because in the marginal costing, we don't have cost of sales. We have variable manufacturing cost. Now, if it was marginal costing, this could have been contribution. So the fact that it's not contribution, but a gross profit, is an indication, or it's consistent with the absorption costing. So that is how you substantiate. You can also add more and substantiate depending to the marks. You can substantiate using the fixed manufacturing overheads. We can't just have fixed manufacturing overheads in the calculation of the cost of a product if we are not using absorption costing. So that is simply your motivation to the answer. Very, very simple theory. Number B, calculate division values total budgeted number of internal sales units to division mountain. How many units is division valley budgeting to sell to division mountain? I think there was an answer for that. 710 73,500. 710 73,500 are the number of units that division valley budgeted to sell to division mountain. Why am I saying that? It is because I can see that under my budgeted, remember I said budgeted, under my budgeted internal sales, see, my budgeted internal sales, meaning to division valley, it is 710 73,500 units. So you don't shy around, you just say straight to the answer, budgeted internal sales from division valley to division mountain, 710 73,500 units. Then after you say refer to, we show the reference, refer to 1.1.1, refer to 1.1.1, then the examiner will go and look for this number and find that you did workings for this number. Very well, there are your workings. Starting from there, 85% budgeted total manufacturing for 2018, then divided that into the market segmentation in terms of sales and production, 65%. So that is the answer for number B. So guys, I'm not going to be writing the answers if I've done the workings, as I mentioned to you before. Assume that AQUA decides to introduce a transfer pricing system. Calculate and recommend a budgeted minimum transfer price per unit of 500 milliliter MD bottle that division valley will be willing to charge division mountain for the 2018 financial year. Provide one motivation to your recommended minimum transfer price. Now, remember they said recommended. I already had recommended for you. I recommended that the price should be R3.35. I recommended the R3.35, if you remember. Now I need to do a little bit of workings here. Now I'll just start with the incremental cost. I don't have to do the workings. I'll just say incremental cost per unit. So we are under number C, if I am not mistaken, solution number C. Yes, that is full 6 marks. So what you do, you show all the workings. But if you have not done 1.1.2, if you have not done this calculation workings, you show all the working from the beginning up until 3 rand 35 cents. As for me, since I do have the workings, I'm not going to be doing that. I'll just say incremental cost. Incremental cost, or all inclusive incremental cost, 3 rand 35 cents. Then I say refer to 1.1 point, just to confirm. Oh, same thing. 1.1.2. Yes, 1.1.2. So the examiner will come here and say all the numbers. Where are my workings coming from? 1.1.2. 1.1.2. That is where this is coming from. Now we need to say, is there an external selling cost? That is only for external sales, but you can do that. External selling cost, we don't have it. Is there a profit that we are making? There is no profit. There is no profit. I think there must be a sentence that says there is no profit made. For all the internal sales, there is no profit made for all the internal sales. There is no profit made for all internal sales. Yes, there is highlighted. There is no profit markup on internal sales. I think I did not read this one before. There is no profit made for internal sales, which means we are correct what we did here by writing this amount of the cost of sales. The amount of the cost of sales there being the same, the selling price, because there's no profit for internal sales. So we are right. I think I did not read that sentence. So since there's no profit on all internal sales, therefore, we can say, plus internal profit. We can say plus internal profit, but let me start with the contribution. There is no contribution on lost sales. And plus, remember, contribution is the opportunity cost, plus internal profit. There is no internal profit. So now that means the recommended transfer price will be 3 rand 35 cents. So this will be recommended transfer price. Recommended transfer price is 3 rand 35 cents. Why am I recommending this price? Now that is the explanation, the motivation. The reason why, it is because Division Valley has enough manufacturing capacity to supply both internal and external customers. Therefore, the minimum transfer price should be equal to incremental cost or equal to variable cost. Why so? Because Division Valley has enough manufacturing capacity to supply both internal and external. Therefore, the recommended transfer price should be equal to the incremental cost of 3 rand 35 cents. So that is your motivation. Please capture such explanation so that you are able to apply in the future. Now we go to the next requirement, requirement number D. Requirement number D says, calculate division values total fixed or total budgeted fixed manufacturing, fixed cost, not manufacturing, total fixed cost that will be used to calculate the division's budgeted break-even point for 2018 financial year. So now that means we are done with this one. Number D is done and dusted. We did calculate our total budgeted fixed cost, and our total budgeted fixed cost amounted to 640,500 rands. So what do you do? You just in your workings, this is number D. In your workings, you say total fixed cost is equal to 564,500. then you tell the examiner to go and refer to 1.1.4. Then the examiner will see where the numbers are coming from. If it's 2 marks or 3 marks, you'll get all your marks. Now, it's very good to be good in analysis of the comprehensive information and be able to analyze and write down, because it helps you in the solution. Calculate division is very actual residual income. Remember, residual income, it is controllable income minus controllable expenses. You get controllable profit minus cost of capital charged. Then this will give us actual residual income. Then after that, based on that, we need to determine and comment on Lehendra's Hendrix division value manager if he will receive a bonus or not. So that is our target, to check if does he qualify to get a bonus or he does not. Now we are busy doing the calculation of the residual income, and that is number E. Now obviously we are looking at this divisional manager who already does have the mini income statement. Very easier for us. Things are made easier for us. So you'll be asking yourself, what do I do, Andile? Do I have to rewrite everything? If you're already done with these workings, you continue with this, then you're done and dusted. You don't have to repeat this. I just not write it down. I just wrote it on the question paper. But if you wrote this on the side, you just complete it and you're done and dusted. By the way, we'll be done and dusted when we do the analysis of this. Now, let me just rewrite it, but it's just the same thing. It's just the same thing. Let me just save time and see how I can deal with this. Let me do this. Wipe this one. Then under operating cost, I erase this one. Then I erase this line. Now we are responding to number D. Let us continue to number D. Now we have our operating cost. Remember, fixed and variable selling costs are controlled by the divisional manager. Interest income is controlled by the divisional manager. Why? Because divisional managers are responsible for the management of cash and cash equivalent. So is entitled to that income. Then under our operating cost, we were told to go to number B. And under number B, we have to first say operating cost. We must write that amount of operating cost because it is already included. Operating cost, our operating cost minus 350,000 rands because of the cost. Then we need to say allocated head office cost. Allocated head office cost. This is 205,000 rands. Remember, the 205,000 rands is included in this 350,000 rands, but it is not supposed to be there because it is the cost not controlled by the manager. Then we have interest on bank overdraft. Interest on bank overdraft. This interest of 4.5 is in that 350,000 rands. Is it supposed to be there? Yes. Why? Because the divisional manager is responsible for the management of cash and cash equivalent. So if the divisional manager would decide what must be done with the funds of the organization. So now for that one, we don't remove it. We leave it as zero. It is already there and we need it to be reducing the income of this divisional manager. The last one is 85,000 municipal rates and taxes, and the municipal rates and taxes are 85,000 rands, and the divisional manager does not have control over this municipal rates and taxes. Therefore, the divisional manager must not be evaluated on the expense that he does not have control over. So 85,000 rands must be removed. So you do this, you draw the box, then after we calculate the total of the other operating expenses. 350,000 rands minus 205,000 rands minus 85,000 rands. If you don't understand why I'm doing what I'm doing, I'll just explain soon why I'm just doing it this way. It doesn't matter. You can say minus 250,000 rands plus 205 plus 85,000. It will give you negative 60,000 rands because 350 is bigger than all these two numbers. Then now we say 369,075 plus, okay, minus 123,310 plus 68,500 minus 60,000 rands. This gives us 254,265. It gives us 254,265. This is our controllable profit. Controllable profit. And now we need to deduct the cost of capital charged, 254,265. 254,265. This is controllable profit. I don't know why is it raising itself. Controllable profit. We just need to deduct the cost of capital charged in order for us to get to the residual income. So now we say deduct cost of capital charged. Deduct cost of capital charged. Cost of capital charged, it is the controllable investment, and our controllable investment was 205,000 rands. It is controllable investment of 205,000 rands times 0.115. I hope you understand what is 0.115. So we deduct 2,050,000 rands times by 0.115. It is 235,750 minus 254,265. We get 18,515. This is what you call a residual income. Residual income. This is our response to the question, 18,515. I wanted to explain something. Oh, we multiply this by the cost of capital charged. Cost of capital is 11.5%. That was our cost of capital. The cost of capital, remember guys, it comes from the financial aspect of this module, which is MAC3761. The aspect where they say, calculate your WACC. Calculate your weighted average cost of capital. After you calculated that weighted average cost of capital, you bring it on this side. This is the percentage we're talking about. So this is one subject, guys. Don't separate the two. At the end of the day, most of the things work together. The financial management aspect with the costing management aspect, they work together. Hence, we see the weighted average cost of capital, which is the WACC. And that WACC is a complete topic in the finance aspect of this, which used to be MAC3702 in the olden days. Now, we are done with the calculation of the first aspect. Then now we are to calculate, we are to evaluate the divisional manager if does he qualify to get a bonus. Now we need to calculate the actual return on investment. We need to calculate the actual return on investment here. Then we know that the actual return on investment, oh, I need to be working inside here because I started here. We need to calculate the actual return on investment. Please bear with me that I'm squeezing things. Actual return on investment. Okay, I do have the writing note here. We have actual return on investment, which is equal to controllable profit. I'm not going to be writing the formula. Controllable profit of 254,000. 265 divided by controllable investment of 2,050,000 rands times by 100. Now let us do the calculation. 254,000 265 divided by 2,050,000 rands times by 100. The divisional manager's actual return on investment was 12.40%. I will just take only two decimal per annum. Now that means the divisional manager did not perform to the standard of the target, therefore he will not qualify to get a return on investment. That is what you conclude. You conclude by saying division value's actual calculated return on investment is 12.40, which is less to the target return on investment, which is less to the target return on investment of 5.50%. It is therefore followed that the division did not meet or exceed the target return of 12.50. As a result, based on division's various actual results, this manager, which is Lehendra Hendricks, will not receive a bonus. So that's why to say you are just saying what is already there. Because the actual return on investment is 12.40, in comparison with the standard return or target return of 12.50, therefore the divisional manager does not meet or either exceed, they said the same terms, or either exceed the target return of 12.5%. As a result, division values actual results for 2018 financial year conclude that Lehendra Hendricks will not receive a bonus. So now you are just telling us what is already there, but in text. So now that is that was in response to question number E. Please, guys, structure workings. I'm just doing this to save time and to show you the importance of analyzing and writing information in details. This was 6 months, 6 marks, and 9 marks. So you grab all those marks. Don't play around with the subject. Don't play around. It will play with you. Now, prepare division mountains production manufacturing budget. Now, we are under division mountain, no longer division valley. The minute they talk about mountain, we need to read about the mountain. That means we are done under number E. Now, we are going to number F, G, H. F, G, and H. Only three requirements. Now, let us read the second information and the last information that is with regards to the second division. Now, hence I say it is important to go through the first division, analyze it deeply, respond to the question that are in alignment with that question. Now, division mounting. Division Mounds mineral water bottling process involves harvesting the natural fresh water from the mountain. I wonder why are they harvesting from the mountain? Because they can buy them from where the waters are being sold. There are animals that need water. There are people who need water who don't afford to buy water. Now, if these big companies can afford to buy water, why are they taking from the nature? They must leave the nature for those that cannot afford water and for the animals that need water. I'm saying this for future purpose, though you might think I'm playing around. Now, they prepare and distill the harvested water and add vitamins and flavor sugar to the prepared water and flavoring sugar to the prepared water. And lastly, bottle the water into the 500 milliliter glass bottle for sale. Then you get it from the shop in a prepared bottle. This was the whole process. Adding the vitamins and flavoring sugar does not increase the volume of the mineral water. And I love this one. They always bring it into perspective, into context, so that you understand things very, very, very well. Because if when we add the minerals, the volume of the water will increase. Therefore, now that will mean when we buy 10,000 liters, we might produce more than 10,000 bottles of water because of the increase when vitamins are added. But in this case, if we buy 10,000 liters, then we'll sell 10,000 liters. Remember, we assume here there is no loss of water. There's no normal loss. There's no abnormal loss. That is the assumption. That means process costing is not the assumption in this topic. However, it can be integrated, and they will tell you that there is a loss of this percentage, then normal loss can appear here, then now that becomes a topic integrated in the same information. Now it further says the division bottles and sell two types of mineral water. Very excellent. Still mineral water, which is STW, and flavored sparkling mineral water. And there's something very crucial highlighted above. They said adding, or they said flavoring sugar. Now this water has sugar. Now the minute there's sugar, we know the side effects of a sugar to a human being or to the life of a human being. Even today you go to the shelves of many of their retail stores, even small business owners, you find a bottle of a drink there. They say less sugar. Why less sugar? Because sugar is impacting humans' lives so negatively. So this company does have sugar. This company takes water that is harvested from the mountain. That is likely not to be good for the sustainability of the organization or for the continuity of the organization. No one would want to buy from a company that killed the citizens of the country. Now, very important for the later question. Then it says the same types of glass is used for both types of mineral water and are different by the bottle caps. A blue bottle cap is used for still water, still mineral water, and a red bottle cap for flavored sugar mineral water. It was flavored sugar or flavored sparkling mineral water. And then it further says further sparkling mineral water. Then it further says a blue bottle, which is a still mineral water, and a red bottle cap for or flavored sparkling mineral water. Then it further says that division purchases all empty bottles, including the related color-coded bottle caps requirements, exclusively from Division Valley. That means everything Division Mountain buys in terms of this container or this bottle that contain 500 milliliter water, they are all bought from one division or one supplier, which is the previous division that we're talking about. Very important to be brought that to our attention. A standard sales mix of 6:2 for still mineral water and flavored sparkling mineral water is maintained through each financial year at any point in time. And all Division Mountain finished goods inventory is held in the same proportion as the standard sales mix. Very important to see that. All, not some, all of them. That means if we have closing inventory of 7,000 units, 6 out of 8 and 2 out of 8 of that 7,000 will be still and flavored sparkling. If we have opening inventory, I want to highlight that, if we have opening inventory of 3,000 units, 6 out of 8 is for the still and 2 out of 8 is for the flavored. So say that if we produce 100,000 or we buy 100,000, remember we are buying from the previous division. If we buy 120,000, or let us say, if we buy or we produce 721,500 as it was budgeted previously, that will be divided, and if we sell all of that. So this is our sales mix. And remember that the previous division, they had their own sales mix, which was in the ratio of 35% to 65%, meaning 35 being external, 65 being internal. Now this division that sells two types of water has their own sales mix of 6:2. Very important to see those differences. No other types of inventories is held by the division. The following information to the 2018 financial year budget. So this is the budget now for this division. Hence, I said we need to do this separately because there will be budget in the other one and budget also in this one. They are budgeting to sell the 500 milliliter bottle at 6 rand 80 cent and 8 rand 10 cent for still mineral water and flavored sparkling mineral water respectively. So these are their budgeted or standard selling prices for these types of water that they are bottling and selling. Then I'd further say that the division is expected to sell a combined 397,750 liters of mineral water during the 2018 financial year. This is what they are budgeting to produce and sell. And it is very important to highlight that this is in liters. Remember, we don't sell a liter, we sell half a liter. Half a liter, it is 500 milliliters. So if we have 2 500 milliliters, this is equal to 1 liter. So now, if we have 1 liter, we produce and sell 2 units. 1 liter is made of 2 units. So now, if they are planning to produce and sell 397,750 liters, meaning they are planning to produce double this in terms of the number of units, but in terms of liters, they are correct, but in terms of the number of units, it is double because each liter is 2 units. So now, in other words, we can clearly say that out of this 393,750, we times this by 2, and we can say that we are targeting to produce and sell 787,500 units. That is under 2.2. That is under 2.2. We are back now to the analysis. 2.2, remember, you must have a heading that says division mounting. Division mounting. We have 2.2. Under our 2.2, we are very, very clear that we are looking at the budgeted sales and production. Budgeted production and sales. They are budgeted production and sales. It was 393,750, if I'm not mistaken. 393,750, we term this by 2. It was liters. Times by 2, which gives us 787,500. Units, 500 milliliter bottles. Remember, it's 2 of them now. So we have our 2 products, which is still mineral water, flavored sparkling mineral water. So now these sales are made in the sales mix. 787,500 times by 6 over 8. 787,500 times by 2 over 8. They have their own market segmentation. Times by 6 over 8. That is 590,625 500 milliliter bottles. Or still water. It's already still water, by the way. 787,500 times by 2 over 8. That is, let me just verify, 787,500 times 2 over 8. It is 196,875 units. Of which the units is 500 milliliter bottle. So we are clear in terms of our plan to produce and our plan to sell. So that was 2.2. We go to 2.3. It says opening inventory was 85,000 units, or is 85,000 units of 500 milliliter bottle. They are very clear now. 75,500 milliliter bottle, but here it was liters. It is very crucial, guys, to highlight all these differences, because you can mess up all your calculations. You just say times by 6 over 8 here, times by 2 over 8, you get your budget completely incorrect. But consistency in your calculation in terms of the right amount in the right place when you calculate future will give you method mark. Then after I say that the 2017 financial year all inclusive actual mineral water manufacturing cost was 5.30 and 6.10, and they say all inclusive meaning all the costs were taken into account. Now remember, closing of 2017 becomes opening of 2018. Now that means again the 75,000 is divided into 6/8 × 2/8. Now we can check how much opening was for each of these product. 75,000 times by 6/8, that gives us 56,250. Then we have 75,000 times by 2/8, that gives us 18,750. These are the opening units for 2018. Then 2018, that is our opening, or these are our opening units, and these opening units costed the company 5.30 and 6.10. So when you're doing the income statement, we need to multiply that and multiply that becomes the value of the opening stock. Then after we have one point, okay, I'll leave these calculations here. We have 2.4. Okay, this 2.3, I think we'll definitely need some workings in the future. I might need these figures. 2.3, we have still water opening stock. We have still mineral water, which is 56,250 and 18,750. Flavored sparkling mineral water. These are the opening units, which makes the total of the 75,000. And be noteful of the fact that this is at the cost of 5.30, and this is at the cost of 6.10 or 6.80 or something like that. Yes, 6.10. These are the allocated cost for this from the previous year. Now we continue on that same note, and I'm not showing the workings here because I've done them here in my workings here. We are told that Division Mountain is expected to operate at its maximum water bottling capacity. Now we don't know what their maximum bottling capacity yet. They say that Division Valley, and I want to make it clear this, it says Division Mountain is expected to operate at its maximum water bottling capacity. We don't know their maximum capacity. They say Division Valley, which is the previous division's budgeted internal sales. So what Division Valley budgeted to sell to us is our maximum capacity. Let me repeat that one. What Division Valley budgeted to sell to us is our maximum capacity. The question, how much did Division Valley plan to sell to us or budget to sell to us? It was 1,190,000 units. That was the budget of Division Valley. Under budgeted 2018, Division Valley budgeted to produce 1,190,000, of which out of that, this was for internal, this is the total, but their plan for internal transfer or internal sales was 773,500. So now in simple terms, that means I have to adjust that one. It is 773,500. So now what Division Valley planned to sell to us is our maximum capacity as Division Mountain. So now, meaning their plan now is to sell a produce and sell at their maximum capacity, which is the plan of the previous division. So now this has to be divided into the ratio of 6 is 2, 8 or 6 is to 2. So now let us do the budgeted production under 2.4. The budgeted production under 2.4, we are looking at the budgeted production. 2.4, budgeted production. Our budgeted production for is equal to 773,500. We have still mineral water. We have flavored sparkling mineral water, which is 773,500 times by 6/8 times by 2/8. 773,500 times by 6/8. Remember, that is in the ratio that they are in the sales ratio that they are operating. 1/25, 773,500 times by 2/8. That is 193,375. So 193,375. So that is their budgeted production in sales, and this is their opening. This is opening stock. This is production budgeted. Now we need to look at the sales and closing. Then we'll be done with one of the questions. Then now we go again to the next part of the question. All empty bottles to be purchased during the 2018 financial year are expected to be fully bottled with the mineral water in the same proportion as the standard sales mix. I love the continuity. Everything that they buy will be bottled. Every bottle they buy will be filled with the mineral water. Either this mineral water is flavored or still, but it will be done in the same sales ratio. They don't play around. Let us just do this. 6 out of 8, it is 75%. Then 2 out of 8, it is 2 out of 8, it is 25%. So 25% will be still water, no, 75% will be still water, and 25% will be flavored sparkling water. So they maintain the same standard sales mix on everything they buy and sell. Empty bottles are currently purchased from Division Valley at a price equivalent to Division's all-inclusive manufacturing cost. That is no profit made on all internal transfers. Take note of that. They say empty bottles are currently purchased from Division Valley at all-inclusive, equivalent to Division Valley's all-inclusive. Remember, the all-inclusive cost per unit was 3.80 rand. 3.35 rand was incremental cost, which was the recommended price that we recommended, because there was no lost contribution and because there was enough capacity to supply both internal and external customers. Therefore, we recommended that they transfer or they sell these units at 3.35 rand. But it says now they are buying at including the fixed cost. But this was our recommended, because that is how we calculate when there's enough capacity. So now we just need here to add the 45 cents in order for it to get to 3.80 rand. So now that means they are buying at all inclusive cost per unit, meaning they are buying at 3.80 rand. So that becomes the cost of the bottle plus the cost of flavoring, the sugar, the vitamins, the branding. So now we need to take all this cost into consideration when calculating the cost of the product in this division. Now, on that same note, now I just want to bring your attention to the fact that this is 3.80 rand of the cost of buying the bottle. Then I would say is the budgeted variable manufacturing cost also include the following. Now we have prepared water of 1.50 rand per liter. Remember, we per liter, we don't want it per liter, we want it per unit. 150 times by 500 divided by 1000, because we need half a liter. So the 150 times by 500 divided by 1000, this gives us 75 cents. So now this will be 0.75, this will be 0.75. 1.5 divided by 2 in simple terms, 0.75. Then we have vitamins for 500 milliliter bottle. This is for 500, for meaning for 1 unit. Flavoring sugar, we don't have flavor on the still, we only flavor the flavored sparkling water. Bottle branding, 15 cents for both of them. What we need now is a glass bottle. We need the glass bottle, which is at 3.80. This will become the cost of the product. Now, we need to take what else into consideration. We'll see as time goes by. There will be fixed manufacturing overheads for this division. Very another part now that is very important. The division's total fixed manufacturing overheads are budgeted to be 712,350. They are now integrating another topic. All allocation of these fixed manufacturing overheads is based on the following relationships between these overheads and their related activities. So now we need to allocate this fixed cost using activity-based costing. We have cost drivers for each of these products. Therefore, now we are to allocate the full of this using activity-based costing. I don't want to go to it now, because I will need the details of that later on in the requirements. But I will write the cost. 2.9, the annual fixed selling cost are budgeted to be 150,000 rands, or 75% of this is for the still water, and the variable selling cost are expected to be 20 cents per bottle. So now we are clear with that. 75% goes to the still mineral water. Budgeted annual other operating costs are 280,000 rands, and they are allocated equally between still water and flavored sparkling water. Let me stop there, then I go to the requirements, because there is an audit report from external auditors. External audit matters, or for external audit matters, there is an audit report. That audit report has its own independent question. So now let me go to the next question and see what to do. We are required to prepare Mountain's production manufacturing budget. Mountain's production manufacturing budget. Now we then need to know our expected sales, our opening, and we also need to know our closing inventory. Then after we have known all of that, it will be then easier for us to then calculate the units that are expected to be manufactured. Then now let us check, how can we calculate our closing inventory? How can we calculate our closing inventory? Because we are provided with all the information opening. We are provided with the units that are expected to be produced, and we are provided with the units that are expected to be sold. Highlight that. We are provided with almost all the information. Budgeted production and sales. This is what they budget to produce, and this is what they budget to sell. Let me just be clear on that one. Yes, this is expected combined. The division is expected to sell. The division expected to sell combined. So this is not production. This is budgeted sales. This is budgeted sales, not production. Budgeted sales only. So this is our budgeted sales. This is our opening. And this is our production. Then we'll get to the closing very easily. Now let us do this for the two products. Budgeted manufacturing budget, we are under number We are under number F. We are under number F. Then we have still mineral water, favorite sparkling mineral water, expected sales. Our expected sales, we calculated 590,000 some odds, if I still remember, was in the same document. We calculated our expected sales, 590,625. Second one, we have 196,875. Then we need to say plus closing. We add closing because closing was produced in the current period. Now, how do we get to the closing now? Very easy. We say our opening for each of them. Opening is 56,250 plus what we plan to produce for that one, which is 580,125 minus what we plan to sell. Our sales are 590,625. This will give us our closing of 45,750. We do the same thing for the second one. We say opening plus production minus sales will give us closing. Our opening is 18,750 plus what we plan to produce. Our planned production, it is 193,375. We deduct what we plan to sell. What we plan to sell, it is 196,875. This gives us 15,250. It gives us 15,250. Then we say plus 196,875. It gives us 212,125. Then we have 590,625 plus 45,750. This gives us 636,375. That is units required. Then after we say less opening. Remember, opening was produced in the previous accounting period, so we don't need to produce it again. Our opening is 56,250 and 18,750. Just verify, there is our opening, 18,750 and 56,625. So we are good to go for that budget. Then we can say minus 56,250. That is 212,125 minus 187,750. We have 240. Nope, it cannot be that small. We have 212,125 minus 18,750. That is 193,000. 193,375. So that is our units manufactured. We have calculated that units manufactured already. So we're just doing it in a more formal way. Now number F is completely done and dusted. We go to number G. Number G requires us to compile the income statement, considering or assuming the given information. Now we are informed that the information here is provided to us. The table or the below two assumptions must only be used to answer question G, H, and I, and assume that production budget is as follows. Assume this is the production budget. So we ignore this budget. In other words, we ignore this budget. Under number G, we assume that we are provided with the information that is in front of us in the solution, where we have sales, closing, opening, and units manufactured. Then after all the other divisions, 2018 financial year information will remain as given in the scenario. We are to calculate the fixed manufacturing overheads per unit that division mountain will allocate to both of the products for 2018 financial year. Then after, we are to prepare the budgeted statement of profit or loss. Let us start with the 6 marks. The 6 marks is a very, 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 very important activity-based costing 6 marks that we must take into consideration. Now, this brings me back to where we ended. Let us first calculate our cost per unit. We need to calculate our cost per unit. Our cost per unit is for the two products, still mineral water and favored sparkling mineral water. We have bottle cost, the cost of the bottle is R3.80 because they are buying it at all inclusive cost. Then after, we have the prepared water. Then we buy the we get the prepared water. The cost of the prepared water, it is 0.75 cents. If you remember that one, we had 0.75 cents and 0.75 cents. Then after, we have the flavoring or vitamins. Do we have vitamins here? Vitamins are 25 cents and 75 cents. 0.25, 0.75. It is the sugar that does not exist on one of the products. Flavoring sugar. We don't have sugar here. Sugar here, it is at 25 cents. Flavoring sugar. Then after, we have bottle branding label, 15 cents throughout. Bottle branding label, which is 15 cents. So this becomes the cost of the bottle. We still have to take into account the fixed cost. We need to take into account the fixed cost and we allocate them here. Now let me do the calculations of this fixed cost separately. We have the still mineral water and flavored sparkling mineral water. That is where now we are allocating the fixed cost, using the activity-based costing. Now, using activity-based costing, remember, we assume the units that are provided in the requirements. We have water testing, water quality testing. Water quality testing. You need to work with me when it comes to this, because I'll do all the workings in here. I'm not going to be showing working separately. Everything will be here. It's only the total that I will bring. They say every 125 bottles is tested. How many bottles are we planning to manufacture? We're planning to manufacture 540,000 and 180,000. Remember, we're using this information now. 540 and 180,000. So now, in other words, we have to say 540,000 divided by 125, every 125. So now we come here and we say we are looking for the pull rates. We say 540,000 divided by 125, it gives us 4,320. Then after we say 180,000, how often do they do the test under the second product? Every 180 units, they do the testing. Every 180, then we say 180,000 divided by 180,000 units, which is 1,125. These are calculations. Then after I get the total plus 4,320, this gives us 5,445, meaning these are the total test for the two products. Then after now, we are doing the actual calculations. So now when you do the actual calculation, what do? We say the rate equals the cost. The rate equals the cost of 163,350 divided by 5,445. This will give us the rate per test. 163,350 divided by 5,445. This gives us 30 rand. And the 30 rand, it is per test. Then now we need to say 163,000. So we need to say 30 times by 4,320 equals, this becomes the total cost specifically for still water. Then we divide this by the number of units, which is 540,000 units. That becomes 24 cents. So now we are allocating that. We say 30 times by 4,320 divided by 540,000. Then we do the same thing. Second one, we say the rate times by how many times the test was done for that product, 1,125 divided by 180,000 units that they are planning to produce. So here we have 24 cents. So that is where the 0.24 is coming from. We have 30 times by 1,125 equals divided by 180,000 units that they are planning to manufacture. This becomes 0.19 cents. Then we come to the second one. Second one, it is the water pump setup. Water pump setup. Just change the color. Water pump setup. Water pump setup is very easy. We already have the total setups. Total setups are easily provided to us. Total is 30 and 45, so that will give us 56 to 75. So the total, it is 75 setups. Therefore, we are looking for the rate. The rate will be the cost divided by the total setups, 225,000 rands. That is 225,000 rands divided by 75. This gives us the rate. 225,000 divided by 75. This gives us the rate. And the rate is 3,000 per pump setup. Then after we do the allocation, then we say 3,000 times by 30 divided by 540,000. This was 0.24 and this was 0.18 times by 30 divided by 540,000 units. This gives us 0.16. Water pump setup 0.16. Let me check the rounding off, which is 0.17. Second one, we do the same thing. We say 3,000 times by the number of setups divided by the number of units. 0.17, and this will be 3,000 times by 45 divided by 180,000 units. This gives us 0.75. Please guys, make it proper when you do the workings. As for me, I'm just making sure that all the numbers that are needed are there and showing all the workings, but not in a very looking good manner. Now for this one, I also have very limited space. 324,000, it says quarter of a minute. Quarter of a minute, it is 15. Quarter minute per bottle, which is 15 seconds. Quarter of a minute, it is 15 seconds. Why am I saying that? A minute is 60 seconds times by 0.25, that is 15 seconds. So now we need to convert that into the number of minutes. Seconds, converting them into minutes, then after we deal with that. Then now let us do that. We are doing the conversion first. We're saying 15 seconds over 60 is equivalent minutes. We multiply that by the number of units. This will give us the total minutes. 15 divided by 60 will give us equivalent minutes times by 540,000. That means we need 135,000 minutes of a fixing branding label. Then second one, let us check if is it the same. Quarter, yes, the same quarter minute, which is 15 seconds. So we say that 15 seconds converted into equivalent minutes. It gave us 0.25 minutes times by 180,000 units. Then this gives us 45,000 minutes. Then that would be 15 over 60 times by 180,000. Then now we need to look at the rate. We need to look at the rate. I did not write the heading here in the beginning. 135,000 plus 45,000. This gives us 180,000 minutes. 180,000 minutes. Then after we then now need to deal with the rate. Then after the rate, I'll just do the calculation and paste the numbers. Then the rate will be the total cost divided by the total minutes, 324,000. We have 324,000 divided by 180,000 minutes. This gives me 1 rand 80 cents. 1 rand 80 cents times by 135,000 minutes divided by 540,000. This is 0.45 cents. That is the allocation, 0.45 cents. Second one, it is 1.8 times by 45,000 minutes equals times by, no, divide by 180,000 units. we need the cost to be per unit 0.45 for both of them. Now we have to say 0.45 plus 0.17 plus 0.24, that will be 0.87. That means the fixed cost, it is 0.27. It is 0.87, that's what we needed. Then for the second product, we had 0.18 plus 0.75 plus 0.45. This is, guys, how you deal with the activity-based costing. 1.38. Then now we can calculate our total cost per unit. That is where everything is going. That is where everything is going. Then I can calculate our cost per unit, 1.38 plus 0.15 plus 0.25 plus 0.75 plus 0.75. We have two 0.75s. Just verify that. Yes, plus 0.75. Then we add, R3.80 plus 3.8. This will give us R7.08. Then we have 3.80 plus 0.75 plus 0.25. Plus 0.15 plus 0.87. This gives us R5.82. R5.82. So now this will be our calculations. 0.45 plus 0.17 plus 0.24. 0.87. So that is correct. That will be R5.82 cost per unit. So we were required to do these workings. We are done with these workings. Don't forget that this 0.45, it is affixing branding label. That is under affixing branding label. I don't want to start a new one. Then you'll have your 0.87 there and your 1.38 there, the total cost, fixed cost, allocated using activity-based costing. With that being said, guys, we have sorted the 6 marks that was required of us. We have dealt with the 6 marks that was required of us. It was which 6 marks? It was this 6 marks. We are done with that one. Then we are to prepare the income statement only for one product. There's still water, only not 2 of them. So now what then becomes important in terms of the cost is the R5.81. The other one is not a necessity. This is our focus. It's all about the one that does not have the sugar. R5.82 is the cost of this product. So now we are doing the income statement. Then we are now approaching the end of everything. We are approaching the end of everything. Then now we are under number G, if I'm not mistaken. We are compiling income statement only for one product. Income statement for still mineral water. We have sales. How many units were they planning to sell? Remember, now our sales are based on their expected sales. Everything is based on the information provided. 555,300 and we are planning to sell these units at 5 rand 30 cents, if I'm not mistaken, at 5 rand 30 cents, at 5 rand 30 cents. This is our budgeted selling price. No, budgeted selling price is 6 rand 80 cents. So that is our budgeted selling price. The 5 rand 30 is the opening cost of the inventory. 6 rand 80. Times by 555,300. 5.82 times by 55,300. This gives us 323,846. 846. That is our sales. Let me verify that we have 6 rand 80 cents times by 555,300. Something is wrong there. We have 3,776,040 rands. Then we have our cost of sales. Our cost of sales have opening stock, and opening stock is valued at 10 cents of that 56,265. I hope I'm correct on that calculation. Ooh, it's the wrong one. Again, we take the one that is given to us. I'm already using the number that are in my mind. Opening stock is the same, 56,250 times by 5 rand 10 cents or 5 rand 30 cents. Verify that cost. It was 5 rand 10 cents or 5 rand 30 cents. Yes, 5 rand 30 cents opening inventory, 5 rand 30 cents for the still water, not 10 cents. 5 rand 30 cents. Very important to verify, there are many figures here. 56,250 times by 5 rand 30 cents. It gives us 298,125. Then we have our production. We are planning to produce 540,000 units from the given information at 5 rand 82 cents. At 5 rand 82 cents, please just guys make sure that rounding off is not a problem, but don't think you'll be penalized. 598,125. Then we say 5 rand 82 cents times by 540,000, 3,142,800. Then we have our closing inventory. Our closing inventory provided in the scenario under the requirements, but at the cost of 5 rand 82 cents, it is 40,950. It is 40,950 at a cost of 5 rand 82 cents. 40,950 at a cost of 5.82 cents. The rounding off might be a difference. I have not verified that, but if there is a rounding off difference of 1 cent, please don't be mindful of that. 5.82 cents. It gives us 238,329. Then this will be the calculation of the cost of sales. 298,125 plus 142,800 minus 238,329. I get 320,0596. 3 million or 322,596 minus 377,640. Then we get 573,444. This becomes our gross profit. This becomes our gross profit. Then we need to less our selling cost. Our selling cost is divided into fixed and variable. There's variable selling cost. They told us that our variable selling cost, I think, was 20 cents. If I still remember, there was a variable selling cost and a fixed selling cost of 75%. There were some numbers of some sorts like that. 75%, 75%, there was 75%. Yes, there we are. 20 cents is variable, and 75% of 150,000 is for still water. 0.75 times by 150,000, it is 112,000. Our fixed 112,500. Our variable 555,300 times by 0.2. That will give us 311,060. Plus 112,500. That will give us 223,560 minus 573,444. No, early to deduct now. We still have other expenses to be taken into account. There should be another expense. Another expense, the budgeted annual other operating cost of 280,000, that is divided equally between the two products. So we have 280,000 divided by 2, that is 140,000. So we need to add that 140,000 as other operating cost. Other operating cost. 140,000. With that, there is nothing else to take into account. Then we can have our gross profit, 573,444 minus 223,560 minus 140,000, we get 209,884. This is profit for the period. This is profit for the period. Now, with that being said, then we are approaching the end. Approaching the end. That is the end. With that being said, there's just one thing that I think will be important to note. 0.17. Just check that. Oh, I think I said 0.18 in my calculation. 0.17 plus 0.45 plus 0.24. Yes, so this is one slight difference that one small mistake that I've made. Here is 0.86 So it will just have slight changes in your calculation. I think my rounding off was just slightly not, was not right. I don't know how I did not do that. You'll get 0.81 here. I'm not going to do the adjustment. I'm just realizing this one. I put a 7 instead of a 6. And I don't know why it was supposed to be 17 or not 18. Or previous, I think I said 18. When I said 30 times by 4,320 divided by 540,000. Not this one. Or is that 3,000 times by 30 divided by 540? Oh, I don't know why I said 18, 0.17. Yes, I did it correct, but in my punching of numbers, I just made a mistake. So please bear with that small adjustment. So your income statement will only be adjusted in terms of your figures here. That will be a 1, that will be a 1. So this figure and this figure will be affected, and also that one. It's only those one that will be affected. Please make that adjustment for me accordingly. Also, for time purposes, I'm not going to be going in details. Let us close now with the last requirement. Very last requirement is just theory. Identify and briefly discuss 4 qualitative factors from AQUAs that could possibly have negative impact on the natural environment and on AQUAs customers. Make use of relevant information from the scenario. I'll just read the scenario. As you can see, the negative impact on the environment, on the natural environment, that we must take negative impact on the natural environment. Now, negative natural impact on the environment says, without qualifying our audit opinion, we bring your attention to the following matters that could directly impact the ability to continue operating as a going concern. The recent changes in the global weather patterns has led to widespread industrial criticism and a call for an industrial overhaul by prominent environmentalists. Of serious concern is AQUA's CO2 emission, which is considered to be amongst the highest in South Africa, mainly because of its bottling manufacturing plant source of energy, which is coal, and coal has negative effect on the environment and human beings. Its landfill site is the largest among its competitors, and inadequate bottling cycling. They remember they are using bottles to pack their products, but we did not hear anything about their recycling strategy. There is no strategy to recycle, and they are using coal that is very bad for their environment. Lastly, we noted with serious concern the possibility of introducing the sugar tax in South Africa, considering the fact that one of the ingredients of AQUA's flavoring sparkling water is flavoring sugar. So now there is a more increase in tax because government is discouraging the consumption of sugar, and the fact that sugar is put on many products. So now the company is using sugar, and that will have impact negatively on human being and the environment at large. Now there's a theory where you just explain all that stuff, how this will affect the environment. And we don't forget the fact that I mentioned before that the harvesting of the natural fresh water is from mountains, yet it's for commercial people. So at least there are people that should be using such water, and animals that need such water from the mountain. So company that afford should be buying water instead of taking natural water. And the AQUA's manufacturing plant is powered by coal, and we know that coal is not regarded as environmental friendly. So now coal will be one of the negative effects that must take into account. And the land that AQUA is using, AQUA is using land site that is bigger among its competitors. So now, in fact, I say that the fact that AQUA's landfill site is largest than its competitors suggests that the company is disposing of more waste than all of its competitors. Therefore, it contributes more on the environment. So they should have a strategy on how to deal with the environmental issues so that the environment is not affected. They don't have adequate bottling cycling strategy. So that is a point of concern. They are using bottles, but there's no strategy on how they are dealing with the environment that they are dominating with the bottles that people they throw whenever they are done with the drinking of their products. And one of the ingredients is obviously sugar. And sugar, there's increased intake in sugar has been linked with the health problems such as obesity, diabetes, and tooth decay. Those are some of the effects of sugar. And this company therefore expected to consider the impact of its flavoring sparkling mineral water, which contains flavoring sugar, on the health of its customers. Guys, with that being said, if you need the theory, you can talk to me. I can forward to the theory. But you just do the summary of the impact of all these things that are put here on the human side and on the environmental side. With that, guys, being said, thank you very much. See you in the next recording.